Here we go.
Here we go. Gentlemen, are we ready?
I don't know. Yes.
Here we go. We are. Yes. It's the Dave Berry Show on Absolute Radio. And what a show, because between them this evening, my guests have brought us Alan Turing, Spider-Man, Billy Elliot, Doctor Strange, Sherlock Holmes, and Khan. Please, ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Tom Holland and Benedict Cumberbatch.
Yeah, thank you.
What
thank you, thank
a treat, gentlemen, it is to have you on the show.
Thank you. That's very sweet. It's nice to be here.
Let's start by saying, in kind of keeping with the style of the movie, is it nice to be doing this together? Is it nice to have a wingman when you're on the publicity trial?
Definitely. And it's 100%. That, yeah, of course it is. It's a relay race then, rather than just some kind of lonely chat.
And Tom, I know you're being a brave soldier today. You're a little bit under the weather.
A little bit poorly today.
Is Benedict looking after giving you?
Me, yeah, I've had my coffee. I'm going to do the lifting for two. It's fine.
Okay.
You can just sit there. Look pretty, it's fine.
Okay, doing a good job. Let's talk about the film, The Avengers Infinity War. It looks so amazing and such an ambitious project, bringing everybody together.
Yeah.
Have you seen the film?
No.
Because obviously there's a lot of CGI
genuinely,
in this.
We haven't seen the film. And, you know, that's true of everyone, right? You just told me
I'm
that even
sure Downey
hasn't,
seen, hasn't
it.
Even no. seen it. No,
RDJ is also not in the know yet.
Obviously, I don't want to go to any plot spoilers as such, but you guys are fighting on the same side, Doctor Strange.
That much we can say. Yes.
That much we can say. When you get the script, is there anybody from the Avengers you're disappointed not to be sharing a scene with? Did you want an opportunity to go toe-to-toe with the Hulk or Thor or any of that kind of...
I'd love to have fought the Hulk at some point.
Yeah.
Because there's a comic book that happens in, and it's a really, really funny story, and it's really cool. But yeah, he's Mark, and I get on really well with Mark. He's a really lovely guy, so he's someone I'd really like to work with in the future.
How does that pan out in the comic book? Who wins that particular?
Well, I mean, you can't really beat the Hulk, can you? I mean, there's only so much you can do. Yeah. But I think they sort of come to a bit of a stalemate.
And Mark Ruffalo, such a wonderful piece of casting for the Hulk, because I've never had the pleasure of meeting him, but he's already one of my favourite people on planet Earth.
He's so funny.
He's a
he
good
really
man.
Makes me chuckle.
And he's really good company. I think from my point of view, it was just an embarrassment of riches who I got to work with. So to sort of then go, ooh, I wish I could be working with someone else is not only an insult, but not really true. I was
that's so true.
Now very happy with what I had on my... You are... No. it really was. It really, really was. So... There's a future possibly if we all survive. Who knows what happens?
Okay. I'm pleased to hear that. What I'd like to do now is get some scenarios, some hypothetical scenarios out there, and for you to tell me which one of your friends, which member of the cast would be best suited to these scenarios.
Oh, cool. Okay.
So let's start with this.
This is where I realise I really don't know my friends at all.
I like that you've shifted and you're saying.
I know. Okay. This is my thinking pose. Yeah. Okay.
Here we go. Benedict, Tom, there's a body in the trunk of the car. Who do you call for help?
RDJ, every
Idris
time.
Elba.
Oh, me?
Are we talking about Doctor Strange or Benedict Cumberbatch?
You're going to give me a choice of cast.
I was
going
to give you choices to make it easier.
So
you jump straight in with there with the body in
the car? I said RDJ. He is the fixer. He's the granddaddy.
Okay.
You know? Yeah.
He'll be honoured with
he's
that.
He's the boss.
But you're talking about the real people, not the superheroes.
Yeah, he's talking about the actors, I guess.
Oh, right, because I was just get you to do the thing.
Oh, yeah, I could portal it away, yeah.
Gone. Oh, you're not using special powers. We're relying on the men and women that you class as friends. And there isn't a real body, by the way.
Just
for all of our reputations.
Yeah. No people have really been harmed in the making of this strange line of questioning.
Yeah, it's a strange line of questioning, is it? So anyway, the body is still in the trunk of the car. Idris Elba, Scarlett Johansson, or Chris Hemsworth?
Hemsworth.
But, you know, Scarlett could distract and just lead attention somewhere else.
But I also feel like Chris could swim it into like the middle of the ocean.
This is true. He could dig a hole bigger and faster than anybody
than any
else.
Human.
Wow.
Yeah, this is true.
That's devious. Even Sherlock would struggle with that devious plot there to get rid of the body.
It's true. It's very good.
Who would win RuPaul's Drag Race? Tom Hiddleston, Bradley Cooper, or Robert Downey Jr.? And by the way, Tom, well done on RiRi, which we loved
Thank
on the lip sync battle.
Yeah, that was extraordinary. That was amazing.
It was, the line between RiRi and Crime Fighter Spider-Man when it comes to the moves is
who
good.
Knows?
It's very impressive.
I think Downey would win a drag race because he has the fastest cars.
Yeah.
Downey has the nicest cars.
Play on
cars.
Words
oh, see, okay,
there, play on words.
It's that
kind of drag race.
Is that what you're talking about?
No, RuPaul, man. get with a broom? I know RuPaul's a motorbike drag queen all the time. No, I'd say.
I do know what that is. Sorry.
When they ask you to do Riri, you're like, yeah, I love driving.
That's why I thought it was so weird when you brought up Riri. I was like, don't talk about drag racing.
I'm a car guy.
Why is it
I see.
Daytona Beach gear. What's going on there? No, I'd say definitely Tom Hiddleston.
Okay.
She can dress up pretty mighty fine.
Which Chris would you let sleep in your spare room for a few nights? Pratt, Evans, or Hemsworth?
If we're talking about sort of cleanliness and just keeping it pristine, I don't know. I think maybe
filthy. Evans.
Pratt, Chris, and I. Yeah, I adore that man.
I don't have a spare room, so my couch is pretty small, so probably the smaller of the three.
Evans,
isn't it?
Just I think Evans is the smaller by, one of
by,
the three.
By a nut's hair, whatever.
Because Chris Pratt is huge. When I first met Chris,
he's a big unit.
He's massive. I think my couch is as big as this little thing.
Okay.
It would have to be the smallest of the three. Yeah. Otherwise, they'd be very uncomfortable.
The Avengers: Infinity War is out in cinemas on April the 27th. Please give it up for Tom and Benedict.
You're so welcome. Thank you very much, guys.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.